For whole color harmony in aesthetic region restorations, it is vital to mimic the incisal transparency. We should send additional data to the technician for him or her to select the type of ceramic powder on this area where enamel exists only and on the whole outer surface. Moreover, we as clinicians can also use the same method for the composite resins to make direct veneer restorations. Although it may differ according to the manufacturers, there are generally three different types of transparency for enamel ceramic or composite resins. Since the light transmittal of the enamel layer in some patients is low, ceramic powder of enamel series should be used for restorations, while others may possess incisal edges with gray appearance or high light transmittance. Therefore, as in this case, where two lateral teeth received laminate veneers, high light transmitting materials should be preferred. But when transparency is considered, it is possible to find ceramic powder or composite resin with two different characters. First one is the transparent or fully clear, and the second one is translucent or half transparent. It is difficult to determine the differences between them clinically by looking at the incisal edges from a frontal view. The most practical solution is to meet a white opaque cardboard with the incisal edge at the palatal side and to observe the color difference while moving it. For example, in this case, the enamel transparency is quite low. Enamel ceramic or composite may work. On the other hand, in the first case of these two patients, where both of them appear quite transparent frontally, no obvious color reflection occurs when white cardboard is applied at the incisal edge. However, in the second case, the white cardboard is clearly observed along the incisal edge. The enamel nearly transmits light and color as a glass. Thus, we have to send the translucency information for the first case and the transparency information for the second case, supported with photographs, to the technician.